North Carolina's rather 9th congressional district. The state's Board of Elections voted unanimously last week not to certify the results amid claims that absentee ballots were tampered with in favor of the Republican candidate. So our next guest helped expose this story. Joining me now is WSOC reporter Joe Bruno. Joe, thank you for being with us. Thank you for your work. I want to start sort of at the end here. You know, you've been on the ground covering the ins and outs of this story. How confident are you that election fraud did take place?
Well, we have people admitting to it. We have people admitting that they went around and picked up absentee ballots. In North Carolina, that's illegal. Not only did they pick up the absentee ballots, they say they didn't put them directly in the mail. They delivered them to McCray Dallas, the man who appears to be at the center of all of this. And not only did they deliver them to McCray Dallas, they say they don't know what he did with them. They don't know whether the votes actually went into the mail from McCray Dallas's office.
And again, you have spoken to people, and we'll get to the journalism aspect of this, the work that you've done on this in a second, but you report that this man, McCray Dallas, who was working, connected to the campaign of the Republican candidate, Mark Harris, you spoke to a woman who says she was paid by him in this case. Explain that.
Yes, two women tell me that they were paid by McCray Dallas. They say they were paid about $75 or $100 a week to go around and collect these absentee ballots. And the way they described it to me, they said there were multiple people being paid by McCray Dallas to do this same thing. And what we are starting to see now is the results. All these absentee ballots, the unreturned ballots, so the ones that were accepted, they're starting to really be scrutinized now, not just in Bladen County, but also Robinson County. And as this investigation continues, I think we'll continue to see more counties throughout this 9th district be looked at.
And again, just for people who are trying to understand what's happening there, and it's complicated, you almost don't have to get past your first sentence there, which is that it's illegal in North Carolina for people to collect absentee ballots. You can't do it unless you are the actual person turning in the ballot or a close relative, essentially, by North Carolina law. One other thing here, so people understand what's going on in one of these counties, Bladen County, only 19% of mail-in absentee voters were registered Republicans, yet 61% ended up going Republican. And just look at that. This chart helps explain the discrepancy there. So there's a data issue here, Joe, which jumps out at people.
Right, and not only that, the results really don't pass the eye test. We can go back to the 2016 primary when McCray Dallas was working for a candidate by the name of Todd Johnson. Johnson was running against Mark Harris and the incumbent, Robert Pittenger. Johnson got 98% of the absentee by mail votes in Bladen County. Mark Harris got 4 votes. Robert Pittenger, an incumbent, got 1 vote. We could be on the ballot, and there's a good chance we'll probably get 1 vote by mistake, let alone an incumbent getting 1 vote in a primary. The 2018 primary, Mark Harris versus Robert Pittenger, Harris received 96% of the absentee by mail votes.
It just doesn't happen in elections. It screams problem. And to a reporter like you, it screams opportunity. Go find out what's going on. And I want to point out, you work in Charlotte, correct? Which is about a 3-hour drive from these counties, or a 3-hour drive from where you're headquartered. What pushed you to go find out more, and how did you do it?
Well, this is as much of a Charlotte story as it is a Bladen County story, because Mark Harris and Dan McCready are both from Charlotte. The district stretches from Charlotte all the way down to Bladen County. It's a really long and interesting district in that respect. But as soon as we saw that the Board of Elections chose to not certify this race, we knew they had to have something big, and we didn't know what it was at first. Eventually, through sources and just being on the ground here in Bladen County, we were able to track down key players by going door to door, stopping by multiple times, and eventually earning their trust to do interviews with us. And that's how we really found out what was going on here.
Yeah, knocking on doors. Sometimes you have to knock on doors and ask people to tell you their story. And when that story is that I went and collected absentee ballots, you know you're on to something. What was your feeling when you had these women admit to you, basically, that there was something that was not right, something criminal here?
What they did was totally illegal, but at the same time, you kind of feel empathy for the people who were involved in this. They seemed sincere when they said that they had no idea what they were doing is illegal. Now, of course, they're working for McRae Dallas, and Dallas has been doing this operation for years, and that's what investigators are trying to figure out is just, you know, how much did everybody know about this? And but this is Bladen County. The average income in Bladen County is about $29,000. It was a community hit hard by Hurricane Florence, and many of the people who were involved in this, who were picking up those absentee ballots, they say they really just needed that extra $75, $100 to help make ends meet. One woman actually told me she needed that extra $100 so she can afford to buy Christmas presents this year.
Oh. So what happens now, Joe? I was reading the Charlotte Observer is actually calling for a new election. Do you think that's a possibility?
It seems like it is a new possibility. What's interesting is if the State Board of Elections orders a new election, we're back to the same candidates, Mark Harris, Dan McCready, and the Libertarian. But if the U.S. House orders a special election, then we're going back to a whole new ball game with a new primary, new general, and everything. There is no timeline for all of this. Of course, new members of Congress are being sworn in January 3rd, but there's a chance that the 9th District could have no representation when that day comes.
That's right. There's a state option here to deal with it. There is a federal House option to deal with it. Well, we don't know which way it will go. That's not clear. What is clear is there is a stink over this election that was exposed thanks to the good work you've done. Joe Urbano, thanks so much for being with us this morning. I fully expect to be working for you someday in the near future. Thanks so much, Joe. Great work.